The following is a presentation of TFNN. Live at TFNN, the Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
Welcome all. We had some kind of technical bug here it is weird. We got ghosts in the machine today. It's unclear why. Anyway, we're going to have a wonderful day, even if we're going to have a slightly abbreviated show. It is another wonderful February 12th at the headquarters of Technical Trading and Investing with me, your humble, lovable, and squeezably soft host, as we take a look at the markets. Certainly looking at the S&P up 17.5 points with 2.36 billion shares as we start off the day. Gold pretty much flat, up $1.60 at 1221. We look at silver up a nickel. Platinum up $4. Crude, probably the most interesting one, is it looked like it was going to go back into that 45 to 48 trading area zone, up almost $2 at $50.67. That may be on the capitulation by several governments in the Mediterranean to ISIS in the last 24 hours. I think that's really just starting to hit the idea that Iran will now control probably four or five countries in the Met, and maybe they'll try to cause some problems to get oil prices higher. But unclear at the moment, other than it has bounced. Natural gas off a little bit, and it's off, at least the UNG's off 48 cents. It is what it is. So we've got a higher price. Not a lot of volume in some some sectors up with very, very light volume. I've got some shorts that are up on, they're on 1 million shares now where they really needed 4 million. So pretty light volume back into these tops. The overall market, Looks to me like maybe a lot of people are deciding they're going to try to go do some bottom fishing in these energy stocks. And why energy is 13% of the S&P, it's correlated to 30% of the moves. So almost the nuclear control rods in the reactor of the market. We also have Apple pushing much higher today, and it's up $1.56. So we had the last few days, of course. It by itself is enough to move the entire tech sector, and it's, since it's such a major piece of all the tech ETFs, if it goes up, it's almost impossible not to make the tech ETF go along with it. Although, you know, you needed about 62 million shares, 68 million shares. You got 58 million shares on Apple today. So are you really breaking out with volume? It's about the same, which means it can go higher over the last couple of days. But it's not the 100 million shares sign of strength at a top where it broke out over the last few days from the previous highs. It's just going higher. And maybe there's enough cult buyers in this or enough people that are willing to buy it. IBM used to be the stock. That was the stock that you couldn't get fired for buying, whether it went up or down, that you just bought it. And if you were a big fund manager, you bought IBM, and that took up a huge amount. And most of the time, it went up over time. But Apple's kind of replaced that in the IBM stable for the stock that you just go buy. Now, the worrisome thing is that we've basically funneled down ourselves to a handful of stocks that the market is driving higher and driving the indexes higher, which makes it kind of probably a little bit of tough for some of the other sectors to come down. But we've got, we'll look at some more of them out here today. But very interesting to see these stocks having kind of an issue, not so much with going up with volume, but going up with light volume. But Apple kind of at least being the tiebreaker out here, holding the rest of the market up. We've got some stocks with the earnings out, and we're going to talk about those today, along with a follow-up of my diatribe on Tesla yesterday. So we'll do that. We'll do that. Everybody in the den. Interesting that we tested 2 minutes before we went on. Audio worked perfectly. Of course, we get started and absolutely nothing. And interestingly, I thought maybe it's a loose cable, something. But no, it just didn't work, and then it did. So hopefully it continues working. Other things of interest out here, of course, we start actually looking at histoire at the beginning of most shows.
That it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
And on this day in 1970, after 178 years, the New York Stock Exchange finally elects its first African-American member, Mr. Searles III. Lest any of its members be embarrassed by having to decide whether to let him sit next to them in the private luncheon club, the exchange gives Searles his own table. I guess that's one way to solve it. I thought this was interesting in the history, and that this is... the month for African Americans. Some of the stories that go around him of being on the stock exchange led to trading places. And there's a great interview. I'm going to have to find it somewhere about the people that wrote Trading Places and the whole thing of, you know, switching Mr. Blue Blood with the street urchin played by, what was his name now? Gumby was interesting. I'm trying to forget his name after just the horrifically bad amount of movies that he's had for forever. Lest it color a really great movie like Trading Places. Anyway, within a year, he didn't even make it 6 months. He's forced to give up his membership that November, but the color barrier has at least been crossed. It was an old boys club, and probably one of the funniest stories ever on Wall Street is a gentleman that you may see from time to time. And his company now is Interactive Brokers, but he was actually the first high-speed, frequency trader by doing a bunch of stuff, and I'll talk about him one day. But probably the best story was no one liked him coming in, and no one would trade with him on the floor as he started his own brokerage in options. So he's Mr. Pettifer, pretty, if you haven't ever seen him on TV. I forget his first name, but his last name's Pettifer. I was actually reading a big book about algorithms and his pioneering of doing the algorithms and coming to the state. Well, Dan Aykroyd was one, but he hasn't made a bunch of stinky movies. He's actually been a bit player in some other ones. I'm trying to think of the other guy from Saturday Night Live, but I can't think of his name anymore because so many horrifically bad movies. Anyway, my point, though, was that probably in one of the funniest episodes of Wall Street and options trading, he started his brokerage, and no one would, if they could, they would avoid his brokers. So he went down to a modeling agency down the street and hired the most beautiful buxom women that he could find. And, of course, most of these guys, if you ever looked at the trading floors or the trading pits, most of these guys are pretty much trolls. They're not hired for their good looks or their good decisions on weight and or hair care. And basically he turned it all around by just hiring really hot women so that the rest of the brokers on the floor would trade with him and pay attention to his gals. And, of course, he eventually opened up Interactive Brokers and went public and ended up, worth about $2 billion last time I looked. But, what do you can? What can you say? Anyway, on this day, he came in, and before the end of the year, 1970, he left. But the color barrier was broken, and since then, not a big deal. But don't hear a lot about it. Mr. Searles. Other things that going on in the market, of course, a lot of earnings. We wanted to get to them fairly quickly because some of these things are falling out of bed. Zulily is one of them. And let me just keep a close eye on the market because I've got some positions I need to babysit here. Let me look at them, just a couple of them. 2.4 billion shares. Eddie Murphy, yeah, that's who it was. Thank you. Nameless caller, Eddie Murphy. What? He was so good, and then he got so bad. It was that Pluto Nash. If anybody's ever seen that stinker, maybe one of the worst movies of all time. But we're already out of time. Anyway, what are we at? Up 15 points on the S&P cash. Everything is awesome. Be back in a minute.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting tfnn.com. Check out the new look of Tiger TV. Now you can see all hosts, charts, and computer screens live in high definition. Whether it's Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, David White, Larry Pesavento, Andy Hecht, Thinkorswim, or Daryl Martin, you can catch all of our technicians hosting their programs live and archived on Tiger TV. Now, crystal clear in high definition, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you haven't seen the new look of Tiger TV, then visit TFNN.com. Grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
You've always taken the long view when it comes to investing, but what if there's an opportunity right under your nose? What if you could be more responsive to market trends to seek to boost your portfolio performance right now while seeking to reduce your overall risk? At Direction Funds, we connect investors with alternative strategies that seek to maximize their returns. Smart investors deserve smart alternatives. Find yours at directionfunds.com. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risk, charges, and expenses of Direction Funds carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction Funds. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact the Direction Funds at 800-851-0511. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. Investing in index funds may be more volatile than investing in broadly diversified funds. Distributed by Rafferty Capital Markets, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Dave, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
And as we come back, are we there? Okay. I don't know why I've got audio kind of coming in and out. I'm going to have to figure that out after the show, but certainly, it's kind of cutting in and out. I may have run over my cables one too many times with a chair or something. As we get back, anyway, we're going to talk about Zulily. And, of course, a few of these stocks really taking it on the chin for a day up. Zulily symbol is ZU out here. Big gap down. We're seeing a handful of these stocks really take it on the chin. This one basically has some lawsuits coming up against it. This is an online retailer. Basically reported revenues that missed expectation. It was down as much as 26% today. Fourth quarter revenues just shy of about $400 million, but estimates were $408 million. And came in at 8 cents a share compared to 14 cents. And that was all they needed to know to pull the plug on this thing as revenues continue to decline. Let's take a little longer look at this thing here, see if we've got anything. Yeah, I mean, this thing, if you just go back, I don't think there's anything else out there. Since the IPO, it's way undervalued out here. The question is, again, if these things break under $10, What is the possibility of them ever getting institutional support from funds again? But this has been a one-way ride down on this. I talked about FireEye and how I've liked it a great deal. We're finally trying to get out of this lower trading range. This was another stock that went to the moon, basically on the thought that since they had such great software that everybody would buy them. My contention is, and still is, that it's very hard for CEOs, if they buy FireEye software, to have plausible deniability. In fact, a lot of people, the original Target retail store hack, let them know that FireEye was on the case then and had, well, in about mid-December, had alerted the CEO about the problems with credit cards, and because he didn't want to mess up a good Christmas season, just ignored it until it blew up in his face in that January season. And we continue to see that, although maybe it's slowly moving. They didn't lose as much money as everybody thought, and a pretty large short position in this. We made some money in this thing, I think, two expiration cycles ago? Was it right before Christmas? I can't even remember now. All I can remember was it was at 27.50. Yeah, it had to be 27.50. It had to be down here. Yeah, that December 16th week. Where we got it, and he made some good money, left some on the table, but I'd been waiting for this thing to actually break the point where it actually makes money instead of loses money. It's just losing less now, but not a bad thing. It is breaking at least the September 11th, 2014 high at 36.85 with a sign of strength. That's big volume and everything else. And maybe the worm has turned for this one. I think it may take a little while. I would like to see this thing come back in on very low volume to maybe that $32 level. And if all the selling pressure got out and maybe they got a little closer to at least break even, I'd be a little happier about maybe buying into this long term. But until then, we need to wait and let me see this thing move. Cake is another one of these big players out here. And, of course, the Cheesecake Factory, one of our favorites, and mostly because it's on the Big Bang Theory. And she used to be, nobody's a waitress there at the Cheesecake Factory. I wonder how much effect that actually has on that. But the Cheesecake Factory, down on heavy volume. You've got a low back here at $42 even on October 23rd. It looks to me like you're probably going to have a good chance come out here. A lot of retail stocks where people thought that they were going to be spending money at these restaurants seems to be maybe a little bit misguided. There was a lot of discussion that Darden and Cheesecake Factory would be the recipients of lower gas prices, but certainly doesn't look like it in the case of Cake. We're already going to break here. We'll be back. We've got a lot of stocks to look at as we check out this market. 2085 on the S&P Cash, up 16 points. 2.48 billion shares.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And kind of interesting as we look at Cheesecake Factory is the data that did come out accompanying Cake and some of the other retailers over the last couple of days. Sales slumped in January about 0.8%, worse than the 0.5% forecast. And following December's 0.9% tumble, total retail sales seasonally adjusted are at their lowest levels since last May, including autos and lower priced gas. They gained 0.2%, half the gain that was expected. So people have a little more cash and they are not spending it or spending on other things like credit cards and paying off Christmas debt, but not going to the Cheesecake Factory. When we look at this, you got heavy volume down. You got a nice untested low at $42 from October 23. And my guess is we're looking at that. Now, some of the other stocks moving out here is Bungie Limited, BEG. This thing's down on pretty heavy volume today. Not uncommon. Was it BG, isn't it? So let's get the news on this guy. Basically off 10% as we speak at 81.37. They had their earnings call this morning, but they're hedging their losses, which it could have been worse. Basically, the takeaway from their conference call this morning is it could have been worse. That means it could have hit $75 today, but they'd hedged some of their losses out. But the quarterly profits fell. And of course, this is a big manufacturer of industrial cranes and digging equipment and that kind of stuff. What do they call them? Drag lines. And I mean, kind of interesting that they've done as well as they have. But down on monstrous volume, you've got a nice gap. To me, this looks like a bigger trading range around to the gap at $74. So we'll probably be looking at that. Cisco out with some decent earnings. I don't think it's kind of interesting to see this stock really run on a great deal of things like firing and firing more and more people. The CEO has said he is leaving, and my guess, he wants to leave and be able to sell his shares at the maximum price available ever. For a stock with 5 billion shares outstanding, a absolute monster move out here for Cisco. Of course, if anybody actually tried selling any of those shares, they would find out how quick they could probably go through the downside on it. This just tends to be one of those stocks closely held, as they said, by people that wouldn't move too far. But on Cisco's benefit, of course, the Internet of Everything is always putting more demand on it. But Mr. Chambers, I suspect, is going to exit with the stock at the highest price possible. The books, if not totally cooked, gently roasted, I would be watching for when he exits stage left. Andy Heck says he called his BG move in his SA article. Well, congratulations, Mr. Heck. I don't know which article that is. Maybe he'll IM me back. Let's see what else we have. Expedia, of course. Expedia buying out Orbitz. Nice pop up here. Monster volume not breaking through the December 5th high that has much lighter volume at 92.08 today, but it has gone behind it and at least staying in the trading range. Kind of interesting to me that this thing could bounce this high on them spending money. I guess the idea is that if they get Orbitz and get together, that it will be Expedia versus Priceline mano a mano, a steel cage grudge match and a duopoly compared to the triopoly that it is now. And I don't know if you can make those kind of adjustments, but the market certainly is saying it can. I think with this kind of volume, you should be breaking through that December 5th high with a sign of strength instead of hitting it and then backing back down. So interesting, but watching it going forward. What else do we have out here? NVIDIA, another one popping rather strongly today. Now, this big breakout, not a big price swing today. NVIDIA. This has always been one that was interesting in that it did not have a dance partner out here. AMD or Intel for putting basically the graphics chips in it. But a nice pop out here just the same, which is kind of tough to figure out. They are making their own chips also for smartphones and doing fairly well out here. I had a good after the hours beat last night. It's up 7% when it opened up this morning. Revenues in the fourth quarter rose 9% year over year to 1.25 billion shares, also topping analyst estimates of 1.15 billion shares. Separately, a bunch of other stuff. NVIDIA's revenue growth slightly outpaced industry standards of just under 10% on the same quarter. Debt to equity ratio is better, powered by strong earnings growth and other important driving factors. The stock has gone higher. Net income growth, blah, 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 blah. But still nice. Archer Daniels, Midland, and Bungie have been crushing it. Bumper crops lead to bumper profits. So if you look that up on Seeking Alpha, you can read his premonition from Andy Heck. And maybe he'll read my future here soon. But I do digress. Nice pop. I would just like to see a little stronger candle than the very tight price range we have today in NVIDIA. all the volume at here. If it comes back to $21.25, that's where you want to be looking at this thing with some light volume. Panera, another one out here today, moving rather strongly. Go find my notes here. Okay, PNRA. It's down 10%. This thing's been in a wild consolidation pattern here from this gap at about 159. That gap started on the 30th of September last year. 1.1 million shares, so not a lot of volume, but it has had a gap that's been acting as support. Came into it October 29th at 160.27 with 2.7 million shares. We're down to that same level. We also had one, on the 8th of December out here with 500,000 shares. This thing did go higher, never really did break out with volume, and this is why you need to be very careful with stocks that don't show a sign of strength. Like a lot of stocks out here, though, needed 1 million shares, got up to a high yesterday, February 11th, 770,000 shares. So still short the million shares it needed from the October 21st high, but went through it twice and then, of course, collapses. And this makes the makes it very hard to short these stocks out here at all-time highs with volume that's not great. But, you know, if it would have had another high up here with 500,000 shares, it would have been something I would have looked at a little bit more. Little pin action out here on TripAdvisor. Nice pop. This has gone right back up into the gap and filled it today. Fairly decent volume. That gap happened on the 5th of November last year. 14 million shares. It's up on 10 million shares, trying to fill that gap for the most part. Kind of tough to see these things go right up, fill the gap, and then start pulling back a little. The volume certainly is there for what we're looking for. Let's read the news on Trip. Hot stock, and just mostly jumps 25% on, very strong sales. User traffic on its website is up. World's largest travel website had a whopping 2.5 billion unique visitors last year. And I don't know what else you need to say out here. Its two biggest growth areas are overseas. Profits from Latin America grew 90% last year, while Europe, Africa, and Mideast region saw revenues rise 40%. So all those terrorists going to the Mideast apparently are using TripAdvisor. Can I read it that way? I don't know. But certainly it is. And, of course, it didn't hurt that Expedia bought out Orbitz, which is OWW. I didn't even look at that yet, so let's bring that up real quick. And, of course, this thing came right back to its monster gap down. And that monster gap happened back on, August 13th of last year. Gap down on 8.7 million shares. And what did it do to come out here today? It just came out, absolutely went right to that gap. Fairly narrow range. And that's, of course, based on the fact that that is the price or close to the price that they're going to get for being bought out here. So I've got a lot of stocks like that. Let's go back here and look at some of the movers over the last few days. We talked about D.H. Horton, and that's always an interesting move out here. Let's see what we got. I got 5 minutes in this segment. Okay. D.H. Horton, we talked about this one going up from previous highs on light volume. Up again today, 2.1 million shares, going up against the January 13th high with 20 million shares. If you want to be more conservative, there is a high from May 15th of 2013, 5.2 million shares at $27.75. Maybe do we tag that? And, you know, you need 5 million shares, 2.1, not doing it for me today. Energy is not all that bad, but it's certainly less than the huge move down from that May 15, 2013 high, where this thing rocketed down all the way to July 8th of 2013. And we've been in kind of a giant consolidation range out here for D.H. Horton since. Other stocks that I wanted to keep looking at, we talked about KKD, another one of these things that came back to its giant gap up level here. And it's doing nothing today. Let's take a look at Lennar and see if we get any action in that. This thing did break out And you needed 10 million shares. On the day that it broke out, it had 3 million shares. Yesterday, it had 2.9 million shares. Today, 1.9 million shares. So you have to be very, very nervous on Lennar. When's the earnings date coming up on this? On March 18th. So you don't have earnings anytime soon. But, boy, certainly don't have a lot of energy back up at these highs. You normally give you 3 days, so unless something happens on this tomorrow, you've got to look at this one as maybe coming back into the trading range fairly quickly. What else do we have out here that I wanted to take a look at? You can always give me a call at 877-927-6648, or you can post a message in the den and or call at or email me at path@tfnn.com. So what else do we have out here? Watch that one real closely. Post properties, PNG, Ultra. Oh, that's what I wanted to look at. The XHB, the home builders out here. And up again today. Energy, not exciting, 3.5 million shares so far today compared to 3.7 million shares yesterday, 5.7 million shares the day before. We want to look at this a little tighter out here. You had a nice spike with lots of volume. That spike was at 35.91 on January 13th this year. And as we've gone through it, 11.4 million shares, kind of the best day that you had. That was on the 4th of February, 6.6 million, 3 million, 2.2 million, 5.7 million, yesterday 3.7 million, today 3.5. So going through and getting above that January 13th spike high was 17 million shares. But I tell you what, the last 4 or 5 days look like a ski slope down of volume on those home builders. So watch those very closely over the next day or two. And take a look at Ultra, ULTA. Ultra Salon Cosmetics and Fragrance. Another one that... I'm really looking at this 134.50 high as this thing plays around these highs. That's the December 5th high. Had some good earnings, a good company. Just wondering if this thing isn't ready for a pullback into that mass. A couple of gaps out there. But the last one was the January 26th high with 137.49. We've gone above it, and we are closed back in that trading range. To me, this thing could easily come back to 105, 104, 103. And if it does it on light volume, this is a very interesting looking company out here. I guess they do a lot of mall kind of things. I don't know them. They're ladies cosmetic company. But had some terrific earnings that really started this off back on September 12th of 2014. And that's continued to move. Zoma, Z-O-M-A. Nothing on that. Ultra QID resources. We'll find a few more here to look at before the end of the day. Out at 2086, 2.6 billion shares. So we'll see how this market closes up here today. Be back in just a minute.
Trade with confidence and clarity while using the software that thousands of institutional traders rely on to make the best and most accurate decisions. Choose from 1,000 equities, currencies, and futures instruments utilizing the TAS architecture. As seen on Bloomberg terminals worldwide, the TAS Profile Scanner is a benchmark technical filtering system that thousands of traders rely on, and now you can too. For a limited time for TFNN subscribers only, we've reduced the price to just $97. That's over 75% off. John Logan hosted a special subscriber-only webinar in December, and you'll gain access to that archive as well, so you can learn exactly what the TAS Profile Scanner can do for you. Try this product out. No matter what you trade, the TAS Profile Scanner can help you make more informed trading decisions. There's no obligation to pay anything. Don't let this offer pass you by. Get your 30-day free trial to the TAS Profile Scanner today by signing up at tfnn.com.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
We're told to follow our passion and everything else will fall into place. I hope that's what each of you are doing each and every day. Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of the Money Master Show at TFN.com, and my passion for technical analysis is what led me to the most fundamental discovery in pattern recognition, the Rhodes Momentum Indicator, Market Scanner, and Trading Strategy, a set of tools that identify the momentum and power of the trend, the likes of which have never been seen before, for every market and every time frame. Yes, folks, the trend is your friend, unless you're on the other side. New to technical analysis? This is the place to start. And experienced traders, take advantage of the trend like never before. Experience the power of the Rhodes Momentum Indicator each day, available to subscribers of my newsletter service, Mastering Probability. I guarantee your satisfaction for the next 30 days, unconditionally, so there's no risk to you other than being on the wrong side of the trend. Mastering Probability, available on the homepage of TFNN.com. And folks, live with passion.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And as we come back, closing up, kind of ticking up a few more ticks up here, but kind of tough to see any kind of volume here, 2.66 billion shares. So volume is a little quiet out here. And, of course, getting ready to go into Friday the 13th, which is not a bad day. So I don't know where I talk about every year about Friday the 13th not being a big deal. Has nothing to do with being unlucky. It has to do with the King of France stealing a bunch of money from the Knights Templar, who had the first ATMs in about 1400, an ATM kind of like thing where you could go and get cash in all the different countries as you traveled around with a letter of intent from them. But, 2087 out here. So we kind of slowly tick up into this market. Other things of interest out here, I wanted to look at a couple more stocks. Pilgrim's Pride out here. We're kind of watching this one, see what happened. It had been kind of meandering along this support line back from the October 16th low of last year, 5.4 million shares. Well, yesterday it was doing 2.9 million shares, no big deal, but down, and it's 5.2 million shares. So it is going to go below that low and have more volume when you look back to this one. Let's go back a little bit longer here, 2 years. This is kind of a big deal. You do have one little kind of patch of sand out here at this level with big volume. And that is 10 million shares on the 27th of June in 2014, but not a major swing point, just a day that the thing had massive volume. So what you have to worry about is if this thing breaks, certainly looks like it could get back to that $19.23 high from August 5th of 2013. Post properties, those stocks kind of got smacked around a little bit, but are coming back and trying to make highs out here again. Not a lot of energy or volume on Post Holdings, going up against its previous high of January 27th, that had 1.3 million shares. 4 days ago, had 1.5 million shares, but could not hold that high, and now kind of just dipping back. Now, what happened was this actually gap moved up with a sign of strength, with a lot of energy on the 26th of January. What you'd like to see is this thing come down to $43 or $42.50, something like that, with very light volume back into that candle and hold that level with light volume, and maybe you got a chance of getting that. PLCM, another one of these holding the highs up here with lighter volume. You'd like to see this September 4th volume day with 1.5 million shares from last year, 1367. It's gone over it with a lighter volume twice. That is the December 23rd high with 410,000 shares. Got up here with 1.5 million shares on January 26th, but instantly reversed. Now it's trying to come back and break through this high yesterday, 1.2 million shares. Today, though, kind of pulling back. You don't want to see it close below 1367 if you're looking for higher prices. OPLK is not one in my list here. Let's see what else we have. I think we have a few more. Let's get, do I have time? No, I don't. We're running out. We looked at Lennar. Oh, we wanted to look at Lorillard. And continues to go higher. And again, it's breaking through that high, but again, no volume. The July 14th high we've been looking at the last few days, 5 million shares. And of course, the last 3 days, 2.2 million, 2.5 million, and 1.4 million shares today. So keep an eye out on some of these stocks up here on light volume breaking out on new highs. We'll see you tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time. Remember to sell when you can, not when you have to. And hang on for Tom O'Brien.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
You're watching Tiger TV.